OS X and iOS are on a collision course. Start buttons aren't the only thing going out of style. Sony's betting on a new OS. And Galaxy Nexus, get 'em while the getting's good. This is Recap Bytes. Hey, it's your friendly interweb party host, Amir. For those who know me, I'm an iOS user who's recently been seduced by an ice cream sandwich. But Apple sensed the conflict within me and launched a first strike for my affection.
Apple is seeking to ban the sale of Galaxy Nexus in the US. I doubt it will end up happening, but it is a ballsy move. Apple has sought injunctions on Samsung devices before, but this will be the first that I'm aware of in the US. In large, this is an attack on Android, not the device itself. The story hasn't really developed, so time will have to tell, but I can't imagine the Galaxy Nexus actually being blocked.
Man, there'll never be better portable gaming than Game Boy Advance SP.
Kaz Hirai, CEO of Sony, has stated that the company will look to expand their Vita OS to other form factors including phones and tablets. The Vita OS recently debuted on the PS Vita. It's in large been despised for its questionable UI choices, but applauded for its speed and responsiveness. It might be a silly move with Sony's recent major Android plays in phones, TV, and tablets, but if they can find a differentiated platform to rally behind, it could go a long way to restoring Sony as a leader in innovation.
So what, you think you can get it fixed? Is this gonna cost money? I mean, you know what you're doing, right? You're a professional. I see how it is. Hey, two, kitty.
Apple surprised us all this week when they showed off the next major version of their desktop OS. Don't let the name fool you. Unlike the transition from Leopard to Snow Leopard, which was primarily back-end improvements, Mountain Lion brings many new features familiar to iOS users. Messages, reminders, and Notification Center, to name a few. More shocking than the sudden announcement, what with Lion having only officially released months ago, is that Apple will be switching to a yearly release schedule for OS X, and that the OS has officially dropped the Mac from its name. I'm extremely excited to see iOS and OS X converging, and cannot wait to get my hands on Mountain Lion when it drops this summer.
Windows.
So I've talked about the lack of a start button in Windows 8, but that's not the only change coming. Microsoft has taken the opportunity to rebrand with a new Windows logo. No longer a flag, the new logo is much more reminiscent of a window and of live tiles. However, as many have noted, Microsoft has missed a major opportunity to unify its branding across all products, a point excellently pointed out by Juan Perez on The Verge forums. His post will be linked in the description.
That's all for today, my funky party peeps, but fret not, I will return on Golden Wings in little more than a week. But pass the time by liking, commenting, and subscribing. So long.